Welcome. In front of me, I have the iPhone 14 Plus, and I would say normally that this is brand new release, but it's been, I believe, a couple of weeks now. It just took it so freaking long to get here, so yeah, I guess I'm gonna do it right now. So I just pop it open. I would normally say there are little pull tabs, but I did already pull them off and made a little bit of a mistake while recording, so this is a rerun. So anyway, I just continue on like this never happened. So we get a phone in here, we get their cable. So this is a Type-C, so you need a Type-C charger if you're planning to use this cable. But the actual other end that plugs into your phone is, I believe this is a lightning port or whatever they're calling it, absolutely garbage. We have a better port now, Apple. It would be really nice if you could get on board with this one, and luckily you don't have a choice anymore. iPhone 15, I believe 15, will literally be forced into using Type-C. So F you, Apple, finally get to use the actual correct plugs and not scam your customers off of money because your cables are garbage. So meaning they do break pretty easily, just so they can charge you more for a new one. Anyway, we get also some stickers and paperwork, so I'm not even gonna go into it. Just eat that to the side and move over to the phone. So there we go, there's the phone, and let's just get it here, power it on. Now, even though this is the 14 Plus version, so not the lowest end, you still get the obnoxious notch. All the advertisements for the dynamic island and all that garbage is gone with the two lower end models. You only get them with the two higher end models, where you spend over a grand. Are you freaking kidding me? So anyway, that being said, this device already retails for about $1,000, comes with a freaking notch in 2022, and honestly, the specs don't really impress here. Now, the reason why I say this is because there is zero reason to buy this phone when the iPhone 13 Pro exists. And the reason I mention this is because 13 Pro is a better device all around, for cheaper, from the same company. So there is a little bit of a problem here, considering this thing costs too much and provides too little over a predecessor that just outperforms this. So just to kind of put that in perspective, I'm gonna first go into specs of this specific device, because that's the video about this one, and later on I'm just gonna kind of give a comparison between the 13 Pro, which is a better pick, and just so you can get a feel of what you get better in that phone. So anyway, with this one, we get a 6.7-inch display. It's a 1284 by 2778 pixels. It puts it at about, 456 pixels per inch. Pretty dense display, to be honest, just like the company. then we get a Super Retina XDR OLED display. Now, just to kind of clarify this, this is just a jargon, and all you get is a basically OLED display. With their slapped on their, like, what is it? I forgot what they're calling it. They have like this weird color thing where they do it, the true tone, and I think that's what they are calling the Super Retina XDR. I think that's about it. It has apparently support for Dolby Vision. It has a typical brightness of 800 nits and peaks at 1200 nits. Last 87.4% screen to body ratio. So those are all the kind of like screen specs right here, which considering you're going to be looking at this display all the time, because that's kind of what you do with the phones, I would say this is a pretty important spec right here. And one thing that you might have noticed is missing in here is the high refresh rate. Who would have thought for $1,000 you don't get a 120Hz refresh rate? Hell, you don't even get 90, because apparently Apple thinks you don't need it for that price. When you're paying, just let me kind of put this in this perspective, when you're paying $1,000, you don't care if you need it or not. You freaking deserve it for this price in the phone. So the price right here is not justified for what you get. Now anyway, moving on, we get the outdated camera setup, basically the double 12 megapixel sensors, same as the previous generation. So we get 12 megapixel wide sensor and 12 megapixel ultra wide. Now the wide one is f1.5, 26 millimeters, then we have the ultra wide at f2.4 and 13 millimeters. Honestly, I don't exactly, let me quickly check, just to compare to the previous ones, same and... Okay, so the ultra wide on the older one, the Pro, has f1.8 instead of the 2.4. So it's a little bit smaller. Anyway, with that being said, the cameras are almost identical, and the benefit of the Pro version of the previous version is it has a third camera, the telephoto one, which this one does not. As you can see, we only have two. And at the front, we have a selfie, and that is also a 12 megapixel wide sensor. So just 12 megapixels all around, you get them everywhere. Okay, moving on. The phone comes with a, again, old processor, which is the previous gen. That's why I'm constantly saying that the 13 might be just a better pick, because this is also coming with a Apple A15 Bionic, just like all the 13 versions of it. But this is a 14, which costs $1,000. Go figure. It has 6 gigabytes of RAM, 128, 256, or 512 gigs of storage. So you can pick between those three. Obviously, pick just whichever one you need in terms of storage. And additionally, if you don't know, you cannot expand storage further past the whatever you buy. So if you think you might need in the future more than you purchase, do automatically go for the bigger storage. Otherwise, you will be just kind of left off with no storage later on. So there we go. And moving on, last thing would be the battery size. So we have a 4,323 milliamp hour battery. So we also have the MagSafe fast wireless charging at 15 watts and Qi wireless charging, just the normal one, at 7.5 watts. And on the cable, it's advertised that it's going to charge your phone up to 50% in 30 minutes. This is advertised, so I'm not sure how accurate it is. That is something to keep in mind. And additionally, the 4,000 milliamp hour battery right here, or over 4,000, 4,300 basically, should last you a pretty decent time. Apple is at least pretty good at optimizing their hardware and software to cooperate really well and consume as little power as it can. And that basically turned out to, for the 13 series, to make some of the longest lasting devices in like their generation or several generations. So hopefully this is the same case here. It's running on the same processor and also iOS, so not much has changed in here. It's basically a iPhone 13 with a slapped on plus one on there. So hopefully the battery lasts just as well, considering if not, what the heck are you paying for? But yeah, so now that I basically mentioned all these specs and just the device, in terms of build quality, it's exactly the same between all of them. We have the, or maybe not all of them, probably the Pro Plus or whatever, or Max has some kind of like titanium grade frame or something like that. I have no clue. This right here is probably just aluminium. I have, actually I have no clue. Let's see if I can quickly find it. So we have glass front, obviously, glass back. So Cornell made glass for both back and front. Yeah, an aluminium frame. So I was correct. So those build quality here will basically be the same for almost every iPhone, even the 13. And now talking about 13, we can move over to the elephant in the room, which is the iPhone 13, which would be the greatest pick over this one. It costs less. And the downside is you do have a smaller battery on the 13 Pro. That is something to keep in mind. It is probably gonna have a bit of a effect on how long the battery will last, though optimization there could have been done a little bit better. I have no clue. I haven't actually checked the battery life of them. So that is something that you might want to check out before actually making the decision. If you really care about the battery life, that is something that you want to check out. If you don't care that much about battery life, because let me just kind of put this out there, the battery life is over 1,300 milliamp hours smaller. So on the 13 Pro, we are dealing with a 3,095 milliamps, while this one right here has a 4,323 milliamps. So quite significantly bigger. But apart from the battery, nothing else here is justified the price, the higher price tag, because the Apple 13 Pro has triple camera setup, all of them being 12 megapixels, so virtually the same as here, just one more. You do have a 12 megapixel front selfie as well. You have the depth sensor at the front. This one does as well. Obviously for the Face ID and all that stuff, you need this. You can record 4K at 60 frames, which I believe you can do here as well. Yep, you can do here as well. You have the same processor, so A15 Bionic, also 60 gigs of RAM, same cameras, a little bit of a smaller display, just because the iPhone 13 Pro was a smaller device. So it came with a 6.1 inch display instead of the 6.7 that you get right here. And obviously, just as before, you do have the notch on the 14 as you did on the 13 Pro. Nothing has changed here. It's, by all intents and purposes, it's exactly the same device, just a little bit bigger. And you don't get that benefit of the 14 little island that you do on the higher grade, and they obviously cost more. So like I said, there is very little reason to go for this specific device when you can get a better one that has a 120 hertz refresh rate, more cameras, and was actually a pro version of this device that costs less than this. So yeah, I would recommend going for the Pro instead of this one if you're planning to pick up one of them. Now, one more thing to say, you could also pick up the Nano Plus. So the iPhone 14, this one will be a bit more more in line to the price, I guess. It's still, in my opinion, a little bit overpriced, but you basically get almost everything that you do right here, and it's not a massive drop, I guess. I'm not sure how to explain this, but the phone will be smaller while still keeping basically everything that this one provides at a little bit smaller price tag. Though don't expect a massive drop in price. It's just gonna be like, what was it? Let me quickly actually check. 14, and we're looking at a price tag of about 770 euros, dollars about. We can probably round it up to about $800, which this one right here costs over 1,000. So you do have a bit of a drop, I guess, of like $200, depending what the actual exact price is that you're gonna pick it up. Obviously different retailers might sell it at different prices, which will just change the perspective a little bit. And one more thing that I will add here is, if this device doesn't sell too well, just generally, if you wait, there is a chance you can actually get it on some kind of discount from different stores and pick it up at a more competitive price that is just more in line with what this device is actually worth. So once it comes to the price of iPhone 13 Pro or even lower, this will be a good pick. Other than that, if it's not coming at like $950 or lower, I probably would not go for it. If the price is just still higher than the 13 Pro, it's not worth it. Now, with that being said, if you found this video helpful, maybe my insight was kind of helpful to you to maybe just decide what iPhone you want to get, don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe, and thanks for watching.